Good morning, church. Good morning. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Announcements this morning. Well, we've got a busy week today. This newsletter, please get those items in if you haven't already. And cleaning bee, who wants to speak to that? Cleaning bee on Wednesday at 10 a.m.
Come and help.
Come and help.
Enough said.
Enough said.
We're starting at
10. 10 o'clock.
And okay. The plan is to work on the basement, but I think we're going to be doing some work up here as well.
Okay.
Sounds like.
Okay.
So,
yes, Mary.
Starting Monday night, we're setting off some fumigation bombs. So please do not come into the church on Tuesday. Give it a chance to settle down.
Okay.
Because we're killing the bugs.
Okay.
So the ladies can take care of them.
Okay. Do we need a shop vac, or is the vacuum cleaner okay? Or?
Hopefully there's not that many bugs.
Okay. Well, let me know if we do. I can always run home and get it. So, okay. So that's Wednesday at 10 o'clock. Plan on being here for that. And this Saturday is the extravaganza, the craft show.
You're at, supposed to say craft show in that little box, but some of my letters were too light to copy.
Oh, was that?
And I forgot to darken them in. I was in a little bit of hurry.
I thought it was RX, you know, or something. I, you know,
like RXW,
whatever. It's a secret passage word. Yeah.
Yeah.
So we're that's
be over there from 9 to 4. So if you're in the area, I hope you'll stop by and say hi at least. It could be a long day.
Well, I hope you have a good time. So,
so
that's that.
With my sister, we will.
You will have a good time. Good. And next Sunday, our DS will be here for, we'll be preaching at 11 o'clock, and then at 12 o'clock, we'll have our potluck, or 12:15, and at 1:30, we're expecting visitors to come and have ice cream with us and with the DS. And so the whole idea is just very laid back and come and get to know the DS, and for her to get to know you. It's just, We've met for many, many times over Zoom, and it just seems like we need to know who she is, and she needs to know who we are. So I'm just delighted that she was able to choose this time, and so we'll have an ice cream social, and I made strawberry jams that didn't set up, so I have 4 quarts of or pints of strawberries that I'm bringing over for our ice cream socials. So don't buy any strawberry stuff if anybody's out purchasing any. I've got lots, so I'm anyway. And then on Monday, the 27th, Vacation Bible School will be here, so to meet and get prepared. You betcha. You bet. Okay. Any other announcements we need to make? Yes, Barton.
I have a clipboard for special music for the month of July.
Okay.
So see me afterwards if you would like to sign up. Please.
Okay. All right. So.
And it's a 5-Sunday month, so there's a sharing Sunday at the end.
Okay. Wonderful. So please sign up for, if not, Barb will come and find you. Thank you. Any other announcements that we need to make? Then, would you please stand and greet each other in the name of the risen Christ? Let us pray. We hunger for the holy, longing for the living God. We gather as children of God, rejoicing in the promise. So let us prepare our hearts for worship.
Amen.
Please join with me in the call to worship found in 798, 1 through 15, and there is only one response. So we'll sing that, the response again. Cry aloud to God, aloud that God may hear me. I will call to mind the deeds of the Lord. I will remember your wonders of old. Your way, O God, is holy. You are the God who works wonders. You manifested your might among the peoples.
You redeemed with your arm your people, the descendants
of
Jacob and Joseph.
Amen.
Stand and sing number 77, How Great Thou Art, verses 1, 2, and 4.
Sweet, sweet in the tree.
Let's now share our joys and concerns this morning, and where have you seen God at work this week in your life? They're going to be paving 34? If you need, yeah, if you, are they going to dig up the top layer of the pavement? Sure. So if you need some gravel, or ground up, yep. Well, there you go. Well, good. So this is an opportunity. Yep, absolutely. So we give thanks for the all the work that the county is doing on the roads. Lord, in your mercy. Yes, Barb.
Well, that, she knew me.
Who can forget you, Grandpa? Well, that's a time of gathering and graduations. We give thanks. Lord, in your mercy. Yeah, I was talking to Pat this morning, and Ryan was climbing his little slide. He gets to the top, but he doesn't quite know how to put his feet down around the slide down. So he went down face first, and of course, you know, catastrophe and crying. And so, Pat misses me. So it's good to feel missed. So we lift up grandkids. Lord, in your mercy. Any others? Well, I have a good friend who has been here, Art Wong. Art and Lynn have come and worshiped here with us here. And Art is the inventor of Swifter. You'll never know that he never gets credit for that, but he invented Swifter. So if you use Swifter, you can thank Art for that invention. He works for Procter & Gamble, and he now has a brain tumor and will be operated on tomorrow. So I'm going to run down to Cincinnati and be with the family for a day, and I'll be back Tuesday night. But I just wanted to let you know, and we want to lift up Art for healing. Lord, in your mercy. And I give thanks for Mary Austin so willingly to find a fishnet for our friends over in Hudson. They had a duck race. The Kiwanis did a duck race, and Mary was willing to go find that, or get Dennis to find the you found the net. Okay.
He had to get it.
He had to get it.
It wasn't.
It's a team effort, right? But they apparently had enough, so they had six nets to get, and hopefully they didn't lose any little rubber duckies. But so we give thanks for all that willingness to help. Lord, in your mercy. Any others? Well, we certainly want to lift up all our fathers and grandfathers and who love and care and help guide our young people. Lord, in your mercy. So let us lift up to God those things that are deep in our hearts in silent prayer. Come, O God, be here with us. As much as a deer longs for streams of cool water, we long to know that you are with us. And when trouble and sorrow come, we need you. Help us to remember that you are always with us and that your love is steadfast. We long for you, O God, discouraged by our flagging efforts. We are afraid of what the future may bring. We separate ourselves from our siblings in Christ because they are different from us. And when we pray, we don't always feel that you hear us. Be present with us. Heal the places of our doubt and despair and alienation. Cure us from hatred and discrimination. Cast out all that keeps us from you and from one another. This we pray in the name and wisdom of Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. As they're doing that, let's consider our offering. And generous God, you are always with us, always caring for us, always drawing us together. And we are so grateful for all your loving presence. We bring our gifts before you today, that this offering may reach out in love to your people everywhere. So let's stand and sing our doxology. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here. Gifts to you this morning, and we remember how dependent we are on your love and mercy for every good and helpful thing in our lives. When we tried to fix things on our own, we have failed, and when we put our trust in your loving power, made known to us in Christ, we have found our lifeline. Dedicate these gifts in our lives that we might not only find our way, but lead others toward Jesus, our rock and our redeemer. Let us remain standing and sing number 480, O Love That Wilt Not Let Me Go, verses 1, 2, and 3. Thank you. Our scripture this morning is Ezekiel 37, 1 to 10. The hand of the Lord came upon me, and he brought me out of by the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in the middle of a valley that was full of bones. He led me all around them, and there were very many lying in the valley, and they were very dry. And he said to me, "Mortal, can these bones live?" And I answered, "O Lord God, you know." And then he said to me, "Prophesy to these bones and say to them, 'O dry bones, I hear the word of the Lord.' Thus says the Lord God to these bones, 'I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. I will lay sinews on you and will cause flesh to come upon you and cover you with skin and put breath in you, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am the Lord.' So I prophesied that as I had been commanded. And as I prophesied, suddenly there was a noise, a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to bone. I looked, and there were sinews on them, and flesh had come upon them, and skin had covered them, but there was no breath in them. And then he said to me, 'Prophesy to the breath. Prophesy, mortal, and say to the breath, Thus says the Lord God, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live.' I prophesied as he had commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood on their feet, a vast multitude." The word of God for the people of God. Pray with me. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. So a teacher gave her grade school students a pop quiz. She wanted to know, and she asked one boy, "Tell me what you know about George Washington. Was he a soldier or a sailor?" "Oh, he was a soldier," the boy replied. "And why do you think that?" "Because I saw a picture of him crossing the Delaware," he said confidently. "And anybody who would stand up in a rowboat sure ain't no sailor." Several years ago, I took a trip with friends out west, and I spoke excitedly about our need to stop at Wall Drugs. I assured him that it would be a fun experience. They couldn't imagine how a drugstore in the middle of a dry, barren badlands could be fun. But when we arrived late in the afternoon, the huge parking lot was filled with hundreds and hundreds of cars. We learned that Wall Drugs was started as a drugstore in 1931. Ted and Dorothy Halstead set up shop, but had little success for many years. They were about to go bankrupt and get out of a place that most considered God-forsaken. However, Dorothy had an idea. They would offer a glass of free cold water to anybody who stopped. They put up a simple sign for free water, and suddenly they could not keep up with all the visitors that were going out of their way to that drugstore. Indeed, people were thirsty, having driven far in the desert land and in need of a cold drink. There was never been a lack of customers since. And every customer would tell their friends that they had to stop at Wall Drugs, and the signs then would, with how many miles to Wall Drugs were found all around the world. They often draw more than 20,000 visitors a day during the summer. Free water. It taught the Halsteads that there were a lot of really thirsty people in the world, and also that no place on earth is God forsaken. The preacher Ezekiel had a challenging church assignment. God sent him to preach to the congregation of Jewish exiles in Babylon. Now they were defeated and they thirsted for vitality. They readily confessed to their new preacher, We are dead. Our homes are dried up. Our hope is lost. Can you imagine a more discouraged church? It's sad when congregations think that way, and it's sad when individuals get into such a state. I'm feeling dead. My bones are dried up. I feel cut off from the living waters of God. Ezekiel was called to preach to such a congregation, and he had no idea what to say. So God gave him a wonderful vision of hope and vitality. The Spirit of God took Ezekiel to an overlook over a valley filled with dry bones scattered on the valley floor. These dry bones had once been vital people of faith. There were no signs of life anywhere. The Lord's Spirit asked Ezekiel, "Can these bones live?" Ezekiel looked upon this dried up congregation and may have said to himself, "There's no way." But it may have been his first appointment, so he said instead to God, "Only you know, Lord." Ezekiel was asked by God to imagine a hope-filled, vital future for them bones. And Ezekiel is called to speak of God's resurrection power in the midst of a cemetery of dried bones. We believers in this church know that the one who raised Jesus from the dead is able to bring hope and vitality to our dry bones as well. The old black spiritual puts life into our scripture. The foot bone's connected to the leg bone connected to the knee bone connected to the thigh bone, and all obeying the word of the Lord. Them bones, them dry bones. God even provides Ezekiel a sermon saying, "I will cause breath to enter you and you shall live. Thus says the Lord God, I'm going to open up your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people, and I will bring you back to the land of Israel. You should know that I am the Lord when I open your grave." Can dry bones live? We know they can. Have you not witnessed this for yourself? Haven't you ever dragged your dry bones to church some Sunday in hopes of some word or song that might bring you back to life? Perhaps after some devastating heartbreak, you manage slowly to resurrect your hope and your vitality again. Maybe after a death of a loved one, you manage to build up a new life of meaning and purpose. Can dry bones live? The God who is able to raise up Jesus from the dead is able to lift us up this morning. We find a similar word of God from the prophet Isaiah. "Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak." That's Isaiah 40. Hope and vitality are gifts from an everlasting God. And we turn to this God through prayer and scripture and song and worship. We drink from the well of everlasting spring, waters that our relationship with Jesus Christ offers us today. Ezekiel brought a word of hope and vitality to the captive Israelites. Don't give up the faith. God is continue to bring great miracles to your lives. The captives were asked to be a shining light of God in Babylon. They were to be a people of hope and vitality until the Messiah would come and be made known to all the world. A few years ago, there's a widely covered story of a 101-year-old man who ran the London Marathon. He ran the whole 26.2 miles. Buster Martin is a hopeful and vital man. He's a man that never gives up. He still works as a plumber 3 days a week. He tried retirement for 2 years, but became bored and went back to work. And he ran the marathon to raise money for a children's charity. Growing older sometimes takes us to a dry and lifeless state, but it's not as exciting to celebrate one's birthdays as it was when you were young. But it would be a mistake to picture ourselves in a valley of dry bones. We would never know what God will ask us to do or preach. Even the finishing stage of our lives can be full of adventures and victories. The changes in our physical strength and capacities may bring forth rich capacities of mind and spirit. Certainly, God will call upon us to live more faithfully and vigorously. We will be given our own visions of hope and vitality. People will change radically as they age. And God still gives us a vision of hope. Like the captives in Babylon, we can be inspired to hold on to our faith and practice. Our confidence in God can be renewed and sustained daily. And we can envision a promising future that God intends for us. The Israelites did not give up hope. And indeed, their faith and confidence in God grew stronger each day, until the day that they were allowed to return to Jerusalem. So let this be a positive vision of hope and vitality for you too. Amen. Let's now turn to number 451, Be Thou My Vision. Please stand. Declare how much God has done for us. Go with me.